Your child had brain or spine surgery and is now recovering. It is important for you to understand what to expect after your child's surgery.
After brain or spine surgery, your child will have swelling and their eyes may seem bruised or swollen shut. Typically, the swelling lasts until 48 hours, and after that, the swelling improves. The surgical site will be closed, either with staples, suture, or surgical glue. There may be a turbine head wrap that'll help prevent some of the swelling that we discussed earlier, and that head wrap may cover your child's eyes. Your child may have IVs in place after the surgery, and these may or may not have running fluid going through them. There typically are armbands that help prevent your child from pulling the IV lines out. So Foley catheter is something that drains urine, and so typically under lung cases, your child may have a Foley catheter.
The child will be on a pulse oximeter, which will measure the oxygen saturation of their blood. It's a little band-aid, basically, that wraps around their finger or toe. They'll also be on a cardiac apnea monitor. The cardiac monitor has three leads, two on their chest and one on their abdomen, and those are also connected to the same monitor as the pulse oximeter. We have them start slowly with clear liquids, either Pedialyte, maybe a popsicle, sips of ginger ale, whatever the child would like, and gradually have them work up to their full diet. Some children tolerate foods right away, others do not. And they'll be getting IV fluids, so they don't need to worry about them becoming dehydrated, because we will keep their IV fluids running at what we call a maintenance rate until they are taking adequate nutrition by mouth. Sometimes parents are scared to hold their child after surgery. We encourage them to hold them. We'll work with them to hold them comfortably. Sometimes it's contraindicated, as in the case of spine surgery where the child needs to be completely flat. But we will prop pillows. We'll help with the tubes and the wires and the monitors to assure that the parent is comfortable. They're allowed to get in the bed with the child if they want to. If it's an older child, that wouldn't be held comfortably. If the child wants the parent in the bed with them, we encourage that also. Whatever's going to make it easiest for the child and the parent is the ultimate goal for us.
After surgery, your child will get medicine. Pain relief pills are given by mouth as needed, and morphine will be given as needed through an IV. If bandages or turban wrap is not used, then antibiotic ointment will be used on the incision. When possible, the staff will also manage your child's pain with singing, toys, or TV. Before your child goes home, it is important for you to understand how your child is feeling. This includes wound care, medicines, warning signs, and when to start activities such as sports.
The child will definitely feel tired and weak following surgery, and that's why we have them increase their activities as they tolerate it. We don't push them too hard to get out of bed. We kind of let them go with the flow, so to speak. Children are very resilient. They'll want to get up. And they could be tired for up to 6 weeks after. They should take naps when they go home, and their usual level of activity will take some time to come back. When a child who's just recently had surgery is discharged from the hospital, we prefer that they go out in a wheelchair or a wagon for their safety. They probably won't be their normal self right away. A child may feel sad, depressed. They may have questions about why this happened to them. I think that that's all very normal. It's just part of the getting better process and having them process the information that's been given to them or the reasons that they've had to have their surgery. Following surgery, your child may have a potential lack of appetite or interest in food. Just encourage them and offer foods that are easy for them to eat that they may find more appealing. And unless it becomes problematic, they should gradually increase their diet and get back to normal.
It is normal for your child's skin to be red around the incision. It also is normal to have a slightly hard ridge around the incision. That's just a sign of healing. The incision will fade over the next 6 to 12 months. There's no need to apply any ointment onto the skin when you go home. The one thing you should do is to avoid sunlight. If there's redness or any swelling around the incision site, you should call the surgeon. Also, if you have questions over your child's temperature greater than 101.5 degrees Fahrenheit, or if there's persistent headaches and nausea and vomiting after the surgery, then those are all good questions to ask the surgeon.
Your child will go home with medicine prescriptions. Before going home, your child's nurse will review these medicines with you and create a medicine schedule for your child if necessary. Get your medicine prescriptions filled at your local pharmacy the day of discharge.
In most cases, any medications that the child was on previous to his surgery, they will continue following surgery, and the doctor will write those prescriptions if needed.
When it's time to go home, patients and families are both excited and anxious, and both of those feelings are very normal. Be rest assured that you're not allowed to go home until the surgeon is comfortable with you being able to take care of yourself at home. So every effort is made to make sure that you're going to be successful at home taking care of your child.
Your child may feel tired when he leaves the hospital. Even though his doctor says he can go back to his daily routine, he may not feel up to it. Your child should pace himself as he recovers. Check with your child's nurse and surgeon to get information specific to your child. Following discharge and once you are back home, here are some tips to help with your child's daily routine. Washing hair in the shower or sink is okay, but avoid dirty tub water. If your child has a spine incision, he should avoid taking tub baths for 2 weeks. A tub bath is fine for your child if he has a head incision. For abdominal or chest incision, use caution, keeping the incision above water level. Remember to use a neutral water temperature and have a parent close by to help. Your child may shower while keeping the incision covered and out of the direct stream of water, with a parent close by to help. Avoid any lifting or strenuous activity for 6 weeks. Walking is recommended, but avoid fatigue. Consult your surgeon and therapist regarding exercise limitations. Use caution when climbing stairs until strength and balance have returned. Discuss driving with a surgeon first. Avoid driving while taking narcotic pain medication if you have limited vision, fatigue, pain, or dizziness. Discuss with your child's surgeon before he returns to school and/or work. Avoid travel until first postoperative visit with your child's surgeon.
Anytime you have questions after surgery, you can either phone the neurosurgical offices here or your primary care physician. There are a lot of questions that can be answered by the primary care physician themselves, but if it's a little bit more in-depth, then feel free to call the neurosurgical offices.
If your child experiences any of these symptoms at home before his first follow-up appointment, you should call your surgeon right away. Increased weakness or numbness of the face, arm, or leg on one side of the body. Decreased vision, loss of speech or difficulty talking, sudden severe headache with no known cause, increased sleepiness or confusion, severe thirst, difficulty swallowing, painful frequent urination or inability to urinate, temperature greater than 101.5 Fahrenheit, leg tenderness or pain. Contact us if you have any questions about your child's recovery. Thank you for choosing Children's Healthcare of Atlanta.